Today we will discuss last call system, which basically deals with first or long distribution. So first let us deal with what is the theory behind last call system. So Erlang determined the grade of service. Generally we know grade of service is denoted as B. So it basically defines the loss probability of a last call system having n different trunks, where we are offering A Erlang of traffic, or we are offering traffic of A Erlang as shown in this below figure. So in this figure we are having a switching system or a switching network in which we are offering A Erlang of traffic with the provided n number of trunks. So the lines that are going out from an exchange to another exchange are called as trunk, we know that. So right now we are having n outgoing trunks, and this defines a simple last call system. So we know we are dealing with first Erlang distribution, that is we are dealing with last call system. So this Erlang solution depends on the following assumption. So four assumptions are made to have a required equation or first Erlang distribution with respect to last call system. So those four assumptions are pure chance traffic, statistical equilibrium, full availability, and calls which encounter congestion are lost. So we already know these two systems or these two assumptions, pure chance traffic. So we know with respect to pure chance traffic, call arrival and call ending are considered as random events, and also the time duration between call arriving and call termination is also considered as random, and the arrival of one call to another call, so that event is also considered as a random event. We know that. So with respect to statistical equilibrium, we know the probability of arrival as well as probability of ending a call remains same inside a busy hour. So coming to a newly assumption, that is full availability and calls which encounter congestion are lost. So let us deal with what full availability is. So of course we have seen this pure chance traffic as well as statistical equilibrium in our previous sections. So that is next coming to full availability. Full availability means that every call that arrives can be connected to any outgoing trunk which is free. So if we are having any outgoing trunk which is free, so if any of these trunks are free, then incoming calls will be processed and forwarded to an outgoing trunk. So we call such assumption as, or such activity as full availability. Full availability means that every call that arrives can be connected to an outgoing trunk which is free. So it is clear that if the incoming calls are connected to the outgoing trunks by switches, that is with the help of switching network, so each switch must have sufficient outlets to provide access to every outgoing trunks. Of course, depending upon the number of trunks, we will have certain number of switches. Coming to the last assumption, that is calls which encounter congestion are lost. So the last call assumption implies that any attempted call which encounters congestion is immediately cleared from the system. When this happens, the user is likely to make another attempt short afterwards. So it is clear that so whichever the calls which encounter congestion because due to non-availability of trunk or non-availability of free trunk for call progression, so such calls will be removed from the system, or such calls are going to be lost. So thus the traffic observed or offered during the busy hour is slightly greater than it would have been if there were no congestion. Generally traffic will be more during busy hours, we know that. So the subject of repeat attempts was engaged. So the subject of repeat attempts has engaged the attention of teletraffic specialists. So there is, so since calls are going to be lost, so a user is going to repeat once again, he tried to connect the calls. So it is very important to know how many repeated attempts are going to be done. So it is a challenging issue with respect to a teletraffic specialist. We need to consider some concentration on the number of attempts being made to a lost call system. And it is very important that, or it is assumed that, the traffic offered is the total arising from all successful as well as unsuccessful calls. So the resulting traffic that is being offered to a switching system is resulting because of successful calls as well as unsuccessful calls. So if the number of unsuccessful calls are increasing and increasing, such thing results in increase in traffic offered to a system. So that's why what we do is, once congestion is observed, so such unsuccessful calls will be removed from the system. So to have Foster-Lang distribution equation, let us consider there are x number of calls in progress, and we know the probability of x number of calls in progress is given by a power x by x factorial into p of 0, where p of 0 denotes no call, probability of having 0 number of calls. However, there could be a, however, there cannot be a negative number of calls. We know we cannot have less than 0 number of calls in progress, and also there cannot be more than n number of calls, since the available trunks are n in number. So it is clear that x can have any value between 0 and n. So since the probability of having calls p of x within this, that is 0 state to n number of, or n number of calls, will be exactly equal to 1. And if I use p of x from this equation, then I will end up with summation x varying from 0 to n a power x by x factorial to p of 0. So now I can write the equation for p of 0. Already we have discussed p of 0 as e power minus a in our previous section or previous class. So right now we will have one more equation for p of 0, and according to this equation, p of 0 becomes equal to 1 by summation x varying from 0 to n a power x by x factorial. So now what we do is, we will substitute this in our basic equation. So if I substitute in place of p of 0, if I substitute this, then I will end up with equation 10 as shown in this equation. So we call this equation as the Foster-Lang distribution. So clearly it is defining Foster-Lang distribution deals with the number of calls that are in progress in a lost call system. Of course, in a lost call system, x can have values only between 0 and capital N. And this is given by a power x by x factorial by summation k varying from 0 to n a power k by k factorial. Of course, here we have used x in place of x, we have replaced with k. So here k also denoting which call we are dealing with, which call we are dealing with. Of course, this summation will be constant for a particular system. Only this varies depending upon what number of trunks are busy, will compute. So this p of x gives the probability of having x number of calls in a lost call system, and that is given by Foster-Lang distribution. So as we know, in a lost call system, calls which encounter congestion are lost. So we will deal with the probability of congestion, the occurrence of congestion. What is the probability of congestion is given by a very important relation called Erlang lost call formula. So the probability of congestion is the probability of lost call, which is the grid of service. So if the call is being lost, so that is defined by grid of service. We know that grid of service plays a very important role with respect to the characteristic of a telecommunication network or a switching network or a switching system. So the grid of service is basically dealing with what is the probability of congestion that we can observe in our lost call system, and that is denoted as E1, N of A. So E1, N of A is defining the grid of service of a given last call system. So which denotes the loss probability of a full availability group of n trunks with offer traffic A along. Of course, we are applying A along of traffic being offered, and of course we are having n number of trunks. We call it as full availability because if any one of the free trunk is there, such trunks will be connected to an incoming call. We know that. So, and this grade of service is defined as B, capital B. We already used this B. B is equal to E1 comma N of A, and that is equal to A power N by N factorial with respect to upon summation K varying from 0 to N A power K by K factorial. Let us call this as equation number 11. And many engineers remember equation 11 as the Erlang lost call formula. So this Erlang lost call formula is also called as Erlang B formula. Erlang B formula because this is defining the grade of service of lost call system. E1 comma N of A is defining grade of service of lost call system. Of course B, and it is having no unit. This B grade of service is having no any unit, and E1 comma N of A is called as Erlang lost call formula, also called as Erlang B formula. So the grade of service of a lost call system with N full availability trunks offered with A Erlang of traffic is given by E1 comma N of A. So we know this E1 comma A N of A is defining grade of service of a lost call system with offered traffic A Erlang. So it may be computed directly or by the iterative application of a simple recurrence relation. So we can compute E1 comma A using this equation 11 directly or with the help of recursive equation or recursive recurrence relation. We can make use of this calculation E1 comma N. We can calculate E1 comma N of A using recursive equation. So we know from equation 11 with N number of trunks I can have this equation. So if I want to calculate grade of service provided by N minus 1 number of trunks, then E1 comma N minus 1 can be written as A power N minus 1 by N minus 1 factorial by summation K varying from 0 to N minus 1 A power K by K minus 1. If I take this to LHS and this to RHS, then equation becomes this. Equation becomes this. And right now in this equation, K is varying from 0 to N minus 1. So, but we know in our last call system, we will be having N number of trunks. So, what we do is, we will increment this. Or we will have N or K varying from 0 to N in this equation. So, if I make K varying from 0 to N, then for this I have to add a power n by n factorial, right? So this becomes our summation equation for summation k varying from 0 to n a power k by k factorial. So now what we do is we will use this in our equation 11, which is our Erlang lost call formula. So in our equation 11, so for this we will calculate or we will substitute the obtained value. So by substituting that, we will end up with this equation. E1 comma N of A to be equal to offer traffic A times E1 comma N minus 1 of A, which is the grade of service with N minus 1 number of trunks, divided by N plus A into E1 comma N minus 1 of A. So the steps involved in finding or in obtaining this relation is shown here. So E1 comma N of A will be equal to, so when I substitute this in my standard equation, so I will end up with this. So when I goes on solving this particular relation will obtain the required result, that is Erlang lost call formula. So this calculation of Erlang lost call formula E1, N of A is directly related with what is the grade of service with N minus 1 number of trunks. Either you can use equation 11 or this equation also. You can call this equation as equation number 12. So please note that E1, 0 should be equal to 1. So if there are no trunks available with certain amount of or with certain offer traffic, if there is no trunk, that means if the number of outgoing trunks are 0, then of course the grade of service will be very large. Of course it will be equal to 1. Grade of service cannot be greater than 1. So this iterative formula enables us to calculate grade of service of a lost call system, that is Erlang lost call formula or Erlang B formula, to be computed for all different values of n.